Hi friends, I am Professor Shalini Tarwade from Mechanical Department. We have started for fourth lecture, unit number 3, Metrology of Screw Thread. Okay. In last lecture, we have seen terminology of gears, in which we have seen pitch circle, addendum circle, then what is addendum, what is dedendum circle, what is dedendum. Again, we have seen concept of pitch, concept of again clearance, backlash, diametric pitch, circular pitch. Okay, now we will move towards next concept, that are various errors in gears. Okay, we will see what are different errors present in gears. Okay, as we all know, there is variation in manufacturing conditions of gears. Okay. Due to these variations in manufacturing conditions, it may lead to many types of errors in gears. Okay, some types of possible errors which are seen in spur gear, helical gear, bevel and arm gears, we are going to see few errors among them which are common in all types of gears. Okay, we will start with adjacent gears. Adjacent pitch error. Okay, before that I will explain you pitch errors. Okay, pitch error is a source of gear noise and character of noise, and this depends upon pitch errors are how pitch errors are produced and how they are distributed. Okay, pitch error is a source of gear noise. It is source of gear noise and it is characteristic of noise. Okay, and it depends, this noise produced depends upon how pitch error is produced and how it is distributed over all gear. Okay, this pitch error is further classified as adjacent pitch error, culminative pitch error and profile pitch error. First we will see adjacent pitch error. Adjacent pitch error is given by actual pitch minus design pitch. Okay, when actual pitch varies from the design pitch, the difference between this both, that is design pitch and actual pitch, gives us adjacent pitch error. Okay, next one, culminative pitch error. When design length is different than actual length, then this culminative pitch error takes place. Okay, what is formula for culminative pitch error? Design length value minus actual length between corresponding flanks of teeth not adjacent to each other. If we want to find culminative pitch error, then we want to take actual lengths between two teeth corresponding flanks of both teeth which are not adjacent to each other. Okay, next type of pitch error is profile pitch error. Okay, the maximum distance of any point on teeth profile and normal to design profile when they coincide at reference point. Okay, it is also difference between design profile point and actual point. Okay, it is maximum distance of any point on our tooth profile, okay, and normal to design profile. Okay, and when they both coincide at reference point, okay, or reference circle. We will move towards next type of errors in tooths. Okay, and it is tooth composite error. Okay, next one is tooth composite error, and they are different for single flank, double flank. Okay, we will first see single flank tooth composite error. Okay, it is range of difference between at displacement at pitch circle of a ear and that of master gear mesh with it at fixed central distance, and this is when it is moved through a distance corresponding to one pitch with other driving and driven flaps, okay, which are in contact with each other. This gives us tit-to-tit composite error. Okay, and it is, again we can take total composite error, between this. It is for single flank, okay? It is range of different errors between displacement at pitch circle of a gear and that of master gear meshed with it, okay? And this is when it is moved from one revolution with only driven and driving flanks which are in contact with each other. This gives us total composite error, okay? What is total composite error for single flank? It is range of difference between displacement at pitch circle of gear and that of master gear. But when it is meshed with fixed central distance, when they are moved through one revolution, one with driving and driven shaft, driven flange, when they are in contact with each other. Okay, now we will see tooth-to-tooth composite error, but this time we will see it for double flank. Okay, it is range of variation in minimum central distance between gear and a master gear when it is rotated to a distance corresponding to pitch of tit. Okay, and total composite error for double flank is given as it is range of variation in minimum central distance between a gear and master gear, but when it is rotated through one revolution. Okay, now we will see next cyclic error. Okay, what is cyclic error? It is error occurring during one revolution of element under consideration. When an element is under consideration and it goes one revolution, the error which is caused is cyclic error. Okay, we called it as cyclic error. Okay, then tooth thickness error. What is tooth thickness error? And error occurring at regular interval of time, okay, not necessary corresponding to one revolution of component. Here one revolution of component is not necessary for tooth thickness error. It is error which takes place after regular interval of time or regular interval of time. Okay, next one, it is periodic error. Okay, now we will see tooth thickness error. It is value obtained by subtracting designed tooth thickness from actual tooth thickness. Okay, when the designed tooth thickness differs from actual tooth thickness, the difference or the value obtained by subtracting the designed tooth thickness by actual tooth thickness, okay, it is by subtracting designed tooth thickness from actual tooth thickness, okay, and when it is measured from a reference cylinder. Okay, now we will move towards next point, that is periodic errors. Periodic errors, as I explained earlier, it does not take place after regular interval of time, and for this one revolution of component is not necessary. Okay, now we will move towards next point, that is runout errors. Okay, what is runout errors? It is total range of reading of fixed indicator with contact points applied to surface rotated, okay, without axis moment about a fixed axis. And when this runout is measured along perpendicular to axis of rotation, it gives us radial runout. And when this runout is measured along parallel axis to the axis of rotation, it gives us axial runout, okay, or OOB. Okay, runout, it's two types, axial runout and radial runout. When measured perpendicular to the axis of rotation, it gives us radial runout. When measured parallel to the axis of rotation, it gives us axial runout. Okay, now we will see eccentricity. It is half the value of radial runout. When half value of radial runout is taken, we get eccentricity. Okay, the due to this presence of these errors, it causes interference in efficient operation of gears. Because of presence of this gear, there is interference in efficiency or in operation of gears. Okay, due to this error, there is non-smooth operation of gear. It also causes noise during operation of gear, okay, thereby reducing working life of that gear. Okay, next type of gear errors are wavelength of an gear error. Okay, the distance between two undulation adjacent crest of an undulation. Okay, as I explained, operation of gears are affected due to presence of these errors, which also ultimately affects the working lives of gear. Okay, these composite errors can be checked, okay, by measuring variations of central distance when this gear is under test, and we perform one test which is called as rolling gear test. Okay, we perform rolling gear test, and the principle of this test is that the total composite variation is measured from central distance variation for one complete revolution of gear. Okay, and by this we can obtain composite error which is present in gear. Okay, there are different methods also, for example Parkinson gear method. Okay, thank you.